Hello guys, I am the biggest numpty in the world because I forgot to save the Last Generations game, meaning my house has disappeared that I made and the family and blah 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 blah. So we've got these guys, sorry about that. We've got Jason Wakefield, who is the dad, Laura Wakefield, the mum, Damien Wakefield is the teenager, Ellie and Alfie. So yeah, we've got the family sorted. Rooms, I've decided to share rooms with the kids this time, like, not in that way, I mean, like, the kids share one room together. Yeah, everything about that sentence was just wrong. Nothing in that was comfortable. Anyway, let me just, so I've got, like, a bunk bed for the two little ones, and then that little one for the single one for the teenager, Damien. But obviously, as Alfie's a little baby at the moment, he can't sleep there, so he has a crib in the parents' room so they can keep an eye on him at night. Oh wow, I'm talking so fast today. So the family's in a pretty good mood at the moment. Let's put these on the wall to make it a bit more homely. So the point in the Generations pack, I think, with you guys is I want you guys to make the decisions so it's like you're playing too. Because you'll notice that in a lot of my videos I ask you questions on what you want to see. Oh, you can read with the kid. That's quite cute. Yeah, of what you guys want to see from these expansions and stuff. I want you to tell me what you'd like for each person or sim. So, like, for Jason, what do you want to see him doing? Like, what, you know, help me plan it out so we get more interaction from you guys. I want you to choose the course of these, their lives, really. Rather than me just sitting here playing it for you. I think that's a bit boring. So write down in the comment sections what you want to see from The Sims. Like, what do you want Damien to do? Do you want him to have a girlfriend? Do you want him to, I don't know, like, stop carrying the kid. How did I get Reed with Alfie up? That's interesting. How did you do that? Oh, was it him? I don't know where the option's gone, but he was going to read with Alfie. Oh, it's there, look. You have to click on the bookcase. Yeah, so tell me what you want to see from this family. How do you want their life to pan out? Do you want him to be naughty, skip school, get taken away? Whatever you get done. I don't know. Opportunities up. Grillathon. What the hell is that? Yeah. So let me know, guys. What does she want to do? Join the medical career. We're not going to enroll in university because we already have a place for that. So he wants to get a part-time job. Let me know what you think of that because I can delete these off if you don't want them to do that. Wear a costume. Become friends with someone. Ah, well, I brought a costume chest, so... an astronaut. Moonwalker White. Go for it, girl. Can he dress up? Oh, that's no fun. Talk to your mum, because... it's nothing better. Shake bra. Do that, whatever that is. Although I'm pretty sure he's not got a bra on. So, for saying they're a family, they're not very close. You can see down here, the bar's like quite low. Oh, look at that, guys. Isn't that a bit cute? Alfie loves being wrapped here. That's a bit sweet. Whoa. Girl. He's going to help his mum out a bit because she's going to do the laundry. Yeah. Do laundry. If there is any. So, Ellie's having fun dressing as an astronaut. Maybe she should play with the doll's house or something. Yeah. So yeah, this expansion generally is all about family life and living as a family. It's about, you know, it's supposed to develop things a bit more, that's all. And what was his characteristics? It's all flirty, he's got commitment issues, he's a snob and he's ambitious. So he's going to be lonely then, by the looks of things. Set a trap. Yeah, let's do that. Let's be a bit of a rebel right now. Go set a booby trap. You should totally set one up, like, on this one as well. Oh, is she going to catch him? Because she... Oh. Oh, shit. Be scolded. She's excited for scolding a child. That's a bit weird. Oh. Whoops. I got in trouble. You are in big trouble, young man. You better not do that again. Maybe you should help around the house to get on my good side. Ah, damn it. Great. How am I supposed to help? Move to dryer? Ugh, the house is pretty clean, so I don't know what I'm supposed to do. Oh, I know what I forgot to buy, guys. A pushchair. Let's take Alfie out for a walk, shall we? Because, I mean, it's a nice day. Where is it? And I forgot to buy a car as well. Great. So let's buy a little family car. Let's have that one. It looks normal. Randomise that colour up. Blue's nice. Nice blue car with a pushchair. This is a pushchair for a boy, so that, oh, that's a bit cute. Yeah, I like that one. So, let's put that by the door. Right, so she's got a pushchair now for the kids, so let's take him out, shall we? Go on a stroll with Alfie. I've not actually seen this done. I know you can do it, so it should be pretty cute. So let's get out of the house and away from the other kids for a bit. Laura Wakefield just picked up Alfie. She will always remember how incredibly soft he felt in her arms. Nice. Aw, look, guys. Isn't that sweet? Oh, that's a bit cute. It's very cute. You can say his name, not Alfie. What's she waiting for? Oh, she's picking him up. I thought she was supposed to be strolling with him in the pushchair. I think she's changed her mind. She don't want to go that way. Alfie, yeah, your name. So it's like, it's almost dinner time, I guess, because I don't know what time you guys have your dinner, but I usually have mine around 6 p.m.-ish, so these guys are going to have it when I usually have mine. That's a bit sweet. Let's look at Alfie. He knows how to say his name. That's pretty cool.
Alfie! Alfie!
But they're houses. It's just quite a nice city. This is in Sunset Valley, which is actually one of my favourites, because the reason it's one of my favourites is because it's got the beach and it's got a nice town life look as well about it, which I quite like. It's a lot like Brighton, in the sense that it's got like, well, actually more Wales, I'd say, because of the greenery and stuff. Looks like Wales, to be honest. But yeah, it's really nice. I used to live in Wales. Bit of a random fact about me there. Lived in Wales for the best part of a year. Really nice. But the weather was a bit rubbish. It rained a lot and it was really cold as well. But at summer, Wales is really hot. But not like, I know that's an obvious thing to say, but I mean like, you catch the sun straight away. So yeah, it's getting late now for this stroll, so hopefully she's heading back home with him. It's getting dark. I think that's a really sweet thing, guys. To be able to take your child on a nice little stroll, get out of the house, away from everyone else. Oh look, that woman's trying to lose weight, she's jogging. Run! Run! Keep running! Running! That's it, run, 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 run. Well, you got to admire her, she's just running in the street trying to lose weight, which is quite nice. I think it's admirational that people want to better themselves. I mean, a lot of people get a lot of slack about being overweight and stuff, but at the end of the day, it's got nothing to do with anyone else. And I think it's great if, because I guess like fat people get a lot of stick for doing exercise because people think they look funny or whatever, but at the end of the day, they're doing exercise, so you can't laugh at them because they're trying to change their lives. And I don't know, I think overweight people should get a bit more respect. It's just my opinion. I mean, you know, not everyone's going to agree, but I don't think overweight people should get as much slack as that, because it's like smokers and drinkers, it's the same thing. If you're overweight, you've obviously got an addiction with food. So I guess it's like their drug. So yeah, I don't know. It's just my thoughts on overweight people. Which is random. Back to The Sims. yeah. So it's getting really dark and she's not gone home with Alfie yet. That's quite worrying. I think she's liking this stroll a bit too much. And I can't actually remember where her house is. Oops. Oh, maybe it is this way. Hopefully she's going home. Where is the house? Huh? So what day is it? It's Sunday, so she's unemployed at the moment. So the kids should be starting school tomorrow. Yeah, so tell me what you want from Alfie. What's wrong with him? Got in trouble, lost a friend. Oh, he's fallen out with his mum big time. That's not good. We really need to build this family relationship up. So I'm sure Alfie's probably getting tired now, you know. Are we almost home? Just picking him up for a bit. What the hell? She's going on a really long stroll. Let's double time this a bit. She went for such a long walk. And it's like dark. She should be home now because the kids are probably like really hungry. Oh, we're back home now. There it is. So we'll take the walls back down. So what's everyone up to in the house? Not a lot. People have just stood around. So I go out for a stroll and everyone's doing nothing. She's still playing with the doll's house. Wow. They all wait for me to come home and to cook. So that's quite funny. Where's she going? No. Go home now. Start walking around. Yeah, that's it. Go home with the child. And get out of the road. You're going to get run over. Silly woman. No safety. Makes me laugh how Sims can just like get run over and they don't actually take an impact or anything from it. Getting run over is non-existent in Sims. Right, so I'm going to feed Alfie. In this high chair area. Put Alfie in the high chair. Let the dad cook the dinner. And then I think everyone can get to bed. He can get the laundry. Oh, it's already been collected. She can carry on playing. I think he should sit down and wait for his dinner to be cooked, or actually look at my monstrous television. Go watch TV for a bit, because really we should be getting the kids to bed soon. Give baby food, especially Alfie. We need to get into bed like ASAP. Yeah, check out this big television, guys. Oh, wouldn't you love a TV like that in your house? And if you have got one like that in your house, whatever. I'm joking. Oh, is the hard chair dirty? What the hell? Clean it. That's it, take the baby out. Oh, wait. Pop him in the crib, put Alfie in there. Okay, is he almost finished with the dinner yet? Call household to meal. Yeah. Which means, why is no one going? That's it. Stop what you're doing. Get your dinner. Oh, right. He sat at the high one. Interesting. He expected her more to sit round this table. So she's putting him to bed. I like this house better than the one I created. It's a bit more family friendly. Whereas the one I created was a bit too big and a bit posh, I guess. That's it, get your food. Right, so he can clean up this high chair. And then I think they should all get to bed. And probably the mother should... Well, actually, the dad can get a job because someone's got to stay home and look after the baby, aren't they? So he's all sorted. So the kids can go to bed. He's not really that hungry. Damien's not, so... Oh, excuse me. Ugh. Sorry if that hurt anybody's ears. Sleep until 7. She can sleep till 7. So there's a lot of cleaning up to do, really. Clean up all dishes and lot. She's already beat you to it, mate. Clean up that. And she can clean up that as well. Oh, she don't like the noise of the dishwasher. Okay. Right. These two can go to bed now, because it's like really late. Can't believe I finally just got the kids and everyone to bed at 3:25 a.m. That's a bit bad, so next episode I'll do better to get them all in bed at a good time. So that's it for this episode, guys, and make sure you catch the next one. And subscribe if you liked it, and give it a thumbs up if you like this video too. And I'll catch you next week. Bye, guys. Oh, if you click here now, you'll be able to go to Sims Island Paradise, where I've just bought it. So I'll be introducing you to that. Bye, guys.